Recently, I had to replace my GoPro Hero 7. I've had this camera for about 5 years, had decent image quality, good stabilization, but like all GoPros, its one tragic flaw is that it would randomly freeze up. Once it freezes up, none of the buttons work. There's nothing you can do except take it out of its cage, open up the battery compartment, pull out the battery, put the battery back in, put it back in its cage, screw everything back together, and then, you know, try again. That happened about 20% of the time. I would film videos, sometimes talk for 5 or 10 minutes, go back and realize, oh, the camera was frozen. I have no footage. But recently, in addition to that, it also started randomly shutting itself off. So it just got to a point where, you know, it had to go and I had to replace it. So I wanted another action camera, and basically there are two competitors to this which are in the same league, and one of them is the DJI Action 4 and the other is the Insta360 Ace. I ended up, after much research, getting the Insta360 Ace Pro. And the reason I got this was, A, it has a very big sensor compared to the GoPro. Lets in a lot more light. It's better in darker situations. It has a flip-up screen. It shoots 8K. And it has, and this was a big selling point for me, an easy mounting system. Now, the camera itself comes with this clip, which has a magnet to guide it to the bottom, because I believe there are magnets here as well. And it also has these recessed buttons on either side. And you push these buttons in, you guide the clip to the bottom, and you're good to go. Or so I thought. Now, these fingers are the same style as what GoPro makes. And first day I had this, I connected it to this little tripod, just as I normally would. And then almost broke the camera because it wasn't actually locked on. You think, and if you watch all the videos, they make it look so easy. You just clip it like this and you're good to go. But guess what? This is not actually connected. See, it pops right off. Didn't make this tight. Pops right off, and it's very deceiving and very dangerous because, let's face it, it's a $400 camera. If you want to connect it securely, you have to kind of faff around with it and push so that it clicks. And now it may or may not be secure. I honestly don't trust it. So there had to be another option for this clip. I think it's poorly designed and it could lead to tragic consequences. Let's put it that way. Now, Insta360, the makers of this camera, they must know that this is a bad design because they actually sell a better one. But it's $50, $49.99, $50 for a clip to enable you to attach this to a chest mount or a tripod. And I'm sorry, but that's highway robbery. So I looked around on Amazon for a third-party clip, and I found one, and it's half the price, which is still way too expensive. This is a knockoff by E Magazine. E Magazine is the company that makes this. But it's a much better design because, number one, it has buttons that come out farther, so they're easier to reach. Because when this camera is mounted on a tripod with this clip that it comes with, it's very difficult for me, especially, to get your fingers under there to get those buttons because the screw is in the way, and it's just a big hassle, and it's really not worth the risk. This one has a much better design. Like I said, the clips are much easier to operate, and it's got a 1/4-20 in here, so you can screw it directly into a tripod with the same kind of mount. And it also has has the feet, the GoPro style feet, so you can use it with this kind of a tripod. Now, let me just show you the difference in how this works. Done. That is secure. I'll try it again. Done. This is not coming off. I trust this one. I do not trust this one. Look at that. There. Now it clipped. It's funny because it makes an initial clipping sound some of the time, and you think it's on. But if you look really, really carefully, you can see that it's not actually connected. Only one side is. And I just can't be bothered with messing around with this. So, just kind of a public service announcement for those of you who have purchased the Insta360 Ace Pro or the Insta360 Ace, get an aftermarket clip if you don't want to spend the $50 for the one that Insta360 produces. You'll be much happier with it. It's much easier. It's a lot more secure, and you don't have to really worry about your camera falling off while you're on your bike or whatever. Yeah, I'll leave a link below to this one, but if you look on Amazon, there are others, some a little bit more. This one was probably the best one that I found. I don't have any affiliation with this company or with Insta360. I just want to do this as a kind of public service announcement to prevent a catastrophe because I almost dropped my camera on the first day. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.